All right, so we looked at calling deep. What are we doing when stacks get shallow? Well, this is where, again, we're going to start appealing to Nash calling ranges. And just like in the button case, we're going to start out with symmetric stack solutions, and then we'll look at asymmetric stacks after that. So we know that shallow button play is often approaching push fold. So that's why those Nash solutions become so useful. Again, the chart works the same as always. Bottom left is offsuit, top right suited. We want to call with all hands with a number greater than or equal to the symmetric effective stack depth. And thankfully, there's no stars or regions or anything complicated. Just call with the hands that have a number greater than the stack depth. Again, there's some weirdness. So this is actually where three-way Nash sort of starts differing from heads-up Nash. And this is a really curious effect. And it's worth a little bit just to at least know about it. It doesn't really end up changing much in terms of our strategy, but it is kind of interesting. So in heads-up play, again, when you're playing Nash and your opponent's playing Nash, if they move to some other strategy, you'll only increase in money. If they go do something really crazy, no matter what thing they do, they'll always do worse than Nash and will always do better. Unfortunately, three-handed, that is not actually a property of Nash equilibriums. The property is that if all three of us are playing Nash, that none of us can improve our equity. So in this context, we're going to be talking about the button range. And so if we're calling Nash in the big blind, and let's assume for now that the small blind's also calling Nash, and the button starts changing his range, what we'll find is that if the button makes his range wider than Nash, it'll actually lower our equity. Our EV will go down when he goes wider. And when he goes tighter, our equity will go up. Now, that doesn't mean that his equity is going up, right? He's not actually increasing. It's not breaking the Nash condition. What's actually happening is that the small blind is having the opposite happen. So when the button shoves too wide, the small blind starts gaining value, and when the button shoves too tight, the small blind starts losing value. While both and in both situations, the button is also losing a little bit of value. So in a sense, like the button loses a little bit and also transfers some of either our money to the small blind or the small blind's money to us. It's a kind of cool thing. It doesn't really end up mattering too much because I should have put these in another order, but even when if we adjust to this too wide button, it'll still lower our EV. So it's not like it's sort of our fault for not adjusting from Nash. It's just sort of an intrinsic property of the game we're playing that like wider shoving ranges hurt the big blind, whereas they help the small blind. You can kind of start thinking about a little bit why. Well, when the button starts shoving wider, the small blind actually benefits because he'll get more value. He'll be able to call and make more money from those extra wide hands. When the button gets tighter, the small blind won't actually benefit because when the button folds, the small blind still has to play against the big blind. He doesn't get any, he doesn't get to keep his blind or anything. He has to suddenly play another push fold game of his own, in which he'll, approximately get, or equities end up somewhere around zero. I mean, it'll be like, maybe 3 BB per 100 or something, but approximately zero. Certainly zero compared to having a small blind. And so when the button open folds, it doesn't help at all, the small blind. It helps the big blind because, because then the small blind can then open fold and the big blind can finally keep his big blind and win a small blind. So on the other hand, of course, the opposite will be true. When the button starts shoving more hands, again, the small blind will be happy because he's going to have to play against the big blind anyways. He doesn't care if button folds. He's just happy that the button is shoving more random, you know, wide hands so that his nutted hands gain more value. And then the big blind won't be happy about this, though, because they're less likely to get their blind back. You know, they sort of lose out on not getting, on having the button open fold. So that's the idea. Just something to think about. Again, not a lot of room where it's going to change your strategy, but it is worth sort of putting out in the open where, you know, why, how Nash is different in three-player games, how you can have these kind of transference effects. And otherwise, though, you know, exploitive play will be the same as in Heads Up Sit and Goes with when you have this situation when you know that the small blind folded. You'll have the same exploitive play. You know, if your opponent's shoving too much, you'll call wider. If he's shoving too little, you want to call tighter.